Cheers, everyone! This is Blaster BrewMaster here, and welcome to Earthbound! A game on the Super Nintendo, a JRPG, JRPG game. Rather infamous game on the Super Nintendo, kind of a very quirky sort of game. And of course, if you play Smash Brothers, you know about the characters Ness. Ness and what was the other one? I don't remember. Anyways, Ness and the other one that's like Ness. How about that? We'll go with that. Well, that's what this game, where they come from, is this game, Earthbound. So let's see. We're going to go ahead and start a new game because I started this one here, P-New. And, well, I just have to re-record the whole thing anyway, so we're going to start this all over again. So, let's see. Please select a text speed. That's fine. Stereo. Good. I want that peanut butter flavored. I like the peanut butter. Oh, we got to name this guy. We can name him Ness. We can name him Pinu, which was supposed to be short for peanut. How about, Lerm? Lerm! No? Sounds too, in all honesty, that sounds too Game Grumps. Let's see. Fork. We'll call him Fork. Just because that's kind of random-ish. I don't want to go Lerm. That sounds just too much like, you know, their thing with Zelda. This will be Fred. Don't judge me. I could call her whatever I want. Alright. This we'll call... I don't think I could do Janet. I'll just go with Jan. You're Jan! And let's see. Next, you! Who are you gonna be? You're gonna be Pebbles! Pebbles! And the dog! Let's call you... Vort. You are Vort. You actually seem like you could have put more characters than most of the other ones. And favorite homemade food? I don't know. What is my favorite homemade food? What do you think it is? Nope. Fine. Sushi. That's my favorite. Don't you enjoy it when you fresh make your sushi yourself? No? I used to try it sometime. I can't honestly say I've done that, but that's besides the point. Favorite thing? Why, beer, of course! What does malt liquor work to get you drunk or quicker? What comes to bottles or cans? Beer! Yes, I'm sure. So, this game is very notorious. It's very quirky sort of game. And I mean, if you look at the art style behind this, and just some of the way that it plays with humor and such, it's the sort of thing that... It was actually one of the inspirations for Undertale, which of course I've been doing some of that recently. I don't know why I want to say it's the inspiration or anything, but Toby Fox did start with making ROM hacks for this game in particular. So that's where some of the ideas and stuff comes from. So let's wait for this little exposition here. Fork's House. That's a perfect name for our name. For a little boy who's going on adventures and should, like, you know, kill things with his baseball bat. Dun-dun-dun! Dramatic entry, ladies and gentlemen! Let's just get going here. Turn on the lights! Hello? Is anybody home? Hello? I think this is the mother. Talk to. What was that noise? Fork! You don't seem scared. Are you nuts? And now you want to go check it out? Oh, okay. Yeah, why not? You'll sneak out of your room anyways, even if I ask you not to. And, you know, I'm not gonna do anything about it anyways, so might as well. Don't really care too much. Yeah, if you get killed, I've got life insurance on you. At least change out of your jammies before you go. Okay. Well, back in the room again. Let's start this up. See ya. Don't really care to talk to you. Okay. So. I can honestly say I've not really played this game. I tried playing it a little bit, but it didn't work out earlier, so trying to do it again. Honor police are infamous for closing roads if something is going on. We are going for the world record. Well, that just kind of... Okay. So that's a great exposition you're having right there. Don't panic, it's just a... What? Meteorite that... fell? I just wanna... I just wanna go home. Okay. Great police officer working you're doing there, police officer. I want to return home, but the road is closed. People are taking this meteorite situation too seriously. Okay. Okay, here we go. Let's see, I wonder if I need to... If I need to go... Over here? I'm trying to remember. I talk to the people in the house... probably not. Let's just go forward and talk to what I'm pretty sure is the Joker from the Dark Knight. Standing there really creepily. I'm waiting for him to try to shoot Commissioner Gordon. A meteorite has landed. The sharks are running wild in town. You kids are wandering around and I'm hungry. I hate my job. You could just quit. What about you? It's dangerous to go to the hilltop. Even if I advise you not to go, it won't stop you, will it? So, you're just not going to do it. Okay. Fine. I don't need parental guidance in here. I'm a little kid with a backpack and a hat. I say fuck the police! I am going on without you people! We're gonna talk to the... No, don't talk to the box. How about we check the box up? Fork opened the prison. There was a bread roll inside. Fork takes it! Because, eating food found in random boxes out in the middle of nowhere seems like the greatest idea. This guy looks creepy. Let's go talk to him!
Hey, Fork! Hiya, buddy. A meteorite fell down and went boom. It was a real mess for a while. I was fine because I always eat garlic and work out to help make my body stronger. That's a weird thing. However, the weaker citizens probably fainted. I'm going to put them in the back of my van and haul them back and give them all the candy in the world. Would you like some, Fork? I also want to tell you... Oops. I almost told you about my dead bodies in the backyard. By the way, Fork, did you check out my billboard? I wrote the message myself. That's my real job, you know. I'm a billboard guy. Why don't you check out my work?
That guy is just so creepy to me. Okay, let's go talk to you. Hey, Fork! Hold on, and my ears itchy.
Hey, Fork! Don't be rubbernecking. You're getting in the cops. Oops! Officer's way! You can get home now. Tomorrow, I, Pokey, will tell you more about the strange meteorite. I'm fine here, but you're bagging the officers.
Okay. Let's talk to this guy. Shh. Alright. Well, fine. I didn't want to talk to you anyways. Clear out! Clear out! Get out of the way! Get out of my way! Clear out! Get out of my way! Okay, I get it. Whoops, my mistake. Get out of my way. Of way, out, get my. Yeah, you did kind of mess up there, didn't you? Okay. You know what? Screw this. I don't need to take this anymore. I'm going home!
Screw you guys! And get him!
Let's see here. Maybe we go this way. And back all the way over here. Da 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 da. Make this whole area a little bit, you know, difficult to get all the way through here. Don't mind me, officer. Kid going home in the middle of the night. Oh, hey there.
Welcome home, Fork. It's not necessary to talk about it tonight. It's late. Scoot off to bed now.
Okay. Sure. Why not? Later that night, and later that night. Hello? Hello? Bit of a funky beat there. Let's go ahead and talk to Fred here. Hey, Fred!
Someone's knocking at the door. What an annoying knock!
Yes, that's gonna be her voice. She has a very lovely voice for a developing child.
My land! Who could be knocking at the door at this time of night? Would you answer it? I'm too afraid and would rather my child die.
Whoa! Okay, Pokey.
Hey, listen to what I've got to say. Well, I told Picky the place where a meteorite landed. Oh, good evening, ma'am. You're looking lovely as usual. Anyways, as I was saying, the police that were guarding the meteorite landing left suddenly to deal with the sharks. You know, the sharks, they're the local ruffians, and they were really going wild. Suddenly, I noticed that Picky was gone. I blame the cops. It certainly wasn't my fault at all. My dad gets back, I know I'm gonna get it. He's gonna give me a butt whooping. You're my bestest friend. Won't you help me find Picky?
No. I really don't like you. Why don't you go away?
If you refuse me, I'll say something that'll cut you like a knife. Will you come with me?
I said no.
Okay. I won't say anything to hurt you. Will you please come with me?
What if I say no again? What'll happen?
If you freeze me, I'll say something that...
Okay, so he just loops over again. Alright, fine.
Okay, good buddy. Let's blow this popsicle stand. Before we go, why don't you say goodbye to your mom? It'll probably be the last time you'll ever see her. Alive, at least. Because I'm going to take your corpse and sell it on the black market.
I know that the dog is unreliable, but you should probably take Vort along.
Cracked Bat in Tracy's room could help out at a time like this. No matter what anyone says, you're a courageous, strong boy, and not a coward like Pokey over there.
Hey, I heard that!
I won't regret anything in what I just said.
You're my very own natural-born fighter. You'll go far. Remember to go for it, especially when giving the girl the D.
Please note that these kids are probably underage anyways.
But I think you should change out of your jammies before you leave.
Yes, ma'am. Again, as usual. Now let's go ahead and break into my sister's bedroom here. Here we go. Let's get this thing right here. I'm gonna talk to it. Dang it.
Always keep getting those two actions confused there. Don't really know about that.
Fork, open the present. There is a cracked bat inside of it. And he goes ahead and takes it. I don't know why they have to keep reiterating some of those things. Okay, so equip cracked bat. There we go. Alright. Let's go on. Wait, what does Fred have to say?
I'll do everything I can to help you. Good luck on your adventure. You might get hungry along the way, so here's a cookie.
Fork got the cookie. Well, isn't that sweet of her?
She's a very sweet and loving child. You can also leave anything you don't need with me. I swear I won't sell it. You want me to hang on to something?
No.
Alright, be careful then.
Alright, let's go ahead and talk to you.
Yeah, sure. You're cool. Whatever.
Okay, that's the weirdest response to my mother ever to have. Go ahead and talk to the dog.
Do you want me to go with you?
Yes.
I guess I have no choice then. Let's go.
Good doggy! Vort joins you. Alright, Pokey, let's go ahead and get out of here.
Alright, you go out front, now follow at a safe distance. Let's keep going.
And a useless weight joined on us. Really? Fine. Oh, no, no, Mom. Just go ahead and stand there. I'll go ahead and talk to this thing. Fork answers the phone.
Hello? It's your dad. Work to exhaustion when you're young. Have you ever heard of weird sayings like this? Just remember, I'm always behind you 100%. Don't be afraid. I know that you're brave. You can do it. Don't forget to call me periodically during your adventure. I can make a record of your progress whenever you call me. Oh yeah, I deposited 30 bucks into your bank account. Do you have your ATM card? Withdraw your money from any cash machine and buy whatever you need. Porn, blow, hookers, liquor, you know, all the essentials in life. Good luck, my boy. I feel like such a hero. What? Well, the father of a hero, at least.
It's just so weird about that. Slam. Beep. But I mean, it's like, just randomly, Pokey just comes and says, hey, I need some help finding my brother. Don't know where he is. You're like, okay, guess I'll go and find your brother. And your father calls and acts like you're some sort of hero. Oh, speaking of which, we gotta smash a snake here. Okay, so go ahead and smash him! Vort growls and lunges forward. Just missed. Pokey plays dead because he is worthless! Coiled snake attacks and apparently got me, and now I can't attack back. Okay, now I can, I guess. Auto fight, whatever. So, that's one thing at least, is I could just pretty much use this to keep doing the attacking. Now I gotta wait because of the fact that it takes a little bit here. And of course, Pokey doesn't do anything useful because he's worthless. Listen to that music. Listen to it. Get down. Get down. Oh, we're done. Sorry. You won! Fork gained one experience. Alright. So let's see here. We gotta go back to the meteorite. 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 And get away from the birds, because I don't really care. I'm just gonna keep going. Should we talk to the creeper? Let's talk to the creeper, I guess. Talk to him.
Hey, Fork. I was too busy to investigate, but I heard a child's voice on the hilltop. I know what it sounds like, especially when it's muffled. I'm a busy man, but when I do a job, I do it well. I'm a man's man. I make sure that I hide my bodies well. So you can be rest assured it wasn't me. Not this time, at least.
Okay. So. Okay. Elf?
If I knew that this was going to be such a scary place, I wouldn't have come along. I'm out of here.
Alright. Fine. What a cowardly dog we got there. Oh, onwards. Go and talk to the kid. Hey, bah!
Oh! You woke me up! Pokey! I've been looking all over for you! You see, Pokey got scared and ran away. Like a wuss. Well, I'm glad you're okay, at least. Let's go home now. I bet Mom and Dad are worried sick about us. Jeez. Sometimes I wonder which of us is really the big brother.
Ta-da! Piggy joins you. Okie doke. Oh,
Fork! Do you hear a buzzing that sounds like a bee flying around?
No.
Oh, come on, you must have heard it.
Can't say I did. No, I'm just hearing Just hearing bugs around us. Pretty sure that's all I'm hearing.
A bee, I am not! Hold on.
Okay.
I am from 10 years into the future! And in the future, all is devastation! Gygas, the universal cosmic destroyer, sent all to the horror of eternal darkness! However, you must listen to the future man! Where I am from, there is a well-known legend that has been handed down from ancient times. It says when the chosen boy reaches the point, he will find the light. The passing of time will shatter the nightmare rock and will reveal the path of light. You see, it is my opinion that you are that boy, Fork. This, I believe. Gygas' monstrous plan must have been set in motion somewhere on Earth. If you start to confront the enemy immediately, you may have time to counter evil inventions.
Intentions.
The evil intentions of Gygas. Three things are of utmost importance: wisdom, courage, and friendship. The legends from the ancient times tells of three boys and a girl who defeat Gygas. I will tell you more later. Go now and do not be anxious about the future. You have much work to do, Fork. Did you listen to what I told you?
Nope. I didn't listen to a damn thing.
I hate to go over it again, but I guess I'll start over.
Now for the quick version.
We'll be here till sunrise.
A bee, I am not. I am from 10 years in the future, and in the future, all is devastation. Gygas, the universal cosmic destroyer, sent all of the horrors of eternal darkness. However, you must listen. Where I am from, there is a well-known legend that has been handed down from ancient times. It says that when the chosen boy reaches the point, you will find the light. The passing of time will shatter the nightmare rock and will reveal the path of light. You see, it is my opinion that you are that boy, Fork. It is, I believe. Gygas' monstrous plan isn't set in motion somewhere on Earth. If you start to confront the enemy immediately, you may have the time to counter the evil intentions of Gygas. Three things are of utmost importance: wisdom, courage, and friendship. The legends from the ancient times tell of three boys and a girl who defeat Gygas. I will tell you more later. Go on now. And do not be anxious about the future. You have much work to do, Fork. Did you listen to what I had to say to you? Yes, this time I did. Sure. Maybe. I'm just gonna go with yes.
Thank you for listening to my long story. You are as exceptional as I expected you to be! Dun 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 dun!
BuzzBuzz now joins you. Okay,
well. Fork! It looks like you're really in a lot of trouble this time. Three boys, he said. I'm not one of those three boys, am I? Cause I'm not into this kind of thing at all. Jeez, my heart is almost pounding right out of my chest.
Yeah, you're just a bit of a coward is all you are, so... pretty sure you're not one of them. Wonder what he says now. Do you say anything different? Have something to tell me? Okay.
Fork, buddy. I have something to tell you, and only you. Can you come visit me later in the back of my van? I'll have plenty of candy for you, as long as you're alone.
Creepy. That guy is very, very creepy. Okie doke. So, I guess we just kind of walk over here and not have to face any enemies or anything. It's at least kind of nice. It's nice to be able to have the little fun moments in life. Oh. Ah! Okay.
It's been a long time, Buzz Buzz. You've been successful at foiling Master Gygas' plans. But, Buzz Buzz, you must now surrender. You're no longer a hero, but a useless insect. I'll stomp on you hard.
Ah. The Starman Jr. blocks my way. Well, let's let them take care of this for you. Buzz Buzz tries a Psy Shield E, and I think everyone is protected by that. So, we'll talk about the commentary here. Pinky's body was protected, Buzz Buzz was protected by the shield, and Pinky goes ahead and attacks 1 HP of damage to the Starman Jr. He is coming out of the small leagues quite well. Quirk attacks, only 1 HP of damage. He's a veteran, he should know better. Starman Jr. is on guard. Buzz Buzz attacks, 76 damage of HP. Oh my, he has some good damage to him. Pokey plays dead, the worthless piece of shit that he is. 2 HP of damage to Starman Jr. Starman Jr. tries Psy Freeze Alpha, but the psychic shield made the Psy Freeze disappear. Now Buzz Buzz tries to put the shield up again. Then the shield became stronger, everyone's shields are becoming stronger, and everyone is being protected, including Pokey, for some unknown reason. I don't know why he's wasting his time with Pokey. Pokey should actually just go ahead and fall apart like the useless refuse that he is. Quirk attacks now with 2 HP of damage, he's doing a little bit better, but he's not on top of his game. Now he tries to use the Psyfire B, and the Psyfire B's spell was dissipated because of all the psychic shields out there, oh my! Now, Buzz Buzz comes back in for the attack, 71 HP of damage to Starman! Now, Pinky comes back in, only 1 HP of damage. One day he's going to be able to actually do some good, but so far he is just not up to game. Seems almost like Starman is just trying, but can't get anything past them. Oh man, the psychic shield that Buzz Buzz keeps throwing up just seems to be blocking him. It's like a cock block. Oh, Buzz Buzz tries the Psy Shield E again and makes that shield even stronger. Oh man, without Buzz Buzz, I feel like this team wouldn't even be able to survive out there, but Buzz Buzz just seems to be able to bring the pain. So, all HP is doing here, Fork attacks, does only 2 HP of damage, oh my. And Starman Jr. tries Psy Fire A again, but still cannot make connection with it. Seems like all of those psychic shields are just doing too good at protecting everyone. Now Buzz Buzz comes back in once more, 35 HP of damage, and Pinky is chanting a magic spell. I didn't even know he could do magic. Fork attacks with 1 HP of damage. Starman Jr. is now on guard, and Buzz Buzz tries to put a psychic shield up again. Almost seems like they're just not going to have to do anything here because the psychic shields are just coming and coming and coming. Now Pinky attacks, comes in with 1 HP of damage to the Starman Jr. Pokey thought to himself, because he's a worthless piece of crap and doesn't have any use whatsoever in life. Starman Jr. is on guard, Buzz Buzz charges forward with 110 HP of damage, that's the most we've seen today! And now they win the game! Woo! Fork gained 16 experience and is now level 2. Offense went up by 1, max HP went up by 3, max PP went up by 2. Now Fork really needs to take a PP. Realizes the power of love. Oh, I mean life up A. Close enough. Now Fork, wow, jumped up to level 3 now. Woo! Guts went up by 1. I wonder what Guts is. Vitality, IQ, max HP by 12, PP by 3. Okay. Whoa! I was taking a big chance there! He came from 10 years in the future to kill me, so we can't relax yet! From now on, you'll be fighting enemies sent by Gygas!
as well as humans who have evil thoughts. They'll definitely make trouble during your adventure. Animals are also becoming violent due to Gygas' influence over the evil in their minds. It is the truth, so listen and believe with your own ears.
All right, so I think we're going to go ahead and call Daddy, Dada, Papa, talk to him and ask for him to save the game.
Fork, it's your dad. I deposited $24 into your bank account. Taking away what you've spent, you should now have $54 in the bank account. Well, XP to get to the next level, Fork, 27. Anyways, what do you want from me?
Go ahead and record if you would, Papa.
Hold on. Your dear old dad was also thinking about hitting the hay for the night. I have created a record of your adventure to this point. Good night and sleep tight.
Alright, well, I think we're going to go ahead and end it for here.
We're a great team, aren't we? Well, you should turn the power off instead of just pressing reset. Alright.
Alright, well, I guess then we definitely will just kind of sit here and we'll turn this off eventually. Anyways, thank you for going ahead and joining me here today on Earthbound. If you like this video, please go ahead and give it a like, give it a comment, give it a subscribe. Let me know that you enjoy these sort of games and these sort of things where I do silly voices all the time for you. In the meantime, go ahead and raise your cannon in the air and have another one on me. Love and peace. Please tell me I'm not gonna have to... Rapid Fire Raptor Gatling Gull. Oh my god, this is the most awesome game I've played in a while. Oh, and I don't have any health. Can I come back? Can I play? Pea Shooter has joined the shootout. I want a quick restart. But crap, that Gatling Gull was amazing. Oh my god, that is the sword.